In the first quarter of 2023, Anaka General Hospital recorded 2,401 cases of malaria. The statistics are raising an alarm in the office of the Nwea District Health Officer.
We have very, very, very high prevalence of malaria. On average, I can say, depending on the seasons and the time when there's rain, sometimes you can have the prevalence of malaria as high as 6 out of 10. Which is about 60%.
Okello Isaac is the acting district health officer of Nwea. As I speak to him, he is worried that malaria cases are overwhelming the district.
I want to start, for example, with the Anaka Hospital. In the months of February and March, I want to give that example. The number of people that were seen having malaria was over 2,401.
The most affected sub-counties are Purong'o, Gotafoyo, and Purong'o Town Council, which all border the Murchison Falls National Game Park. However, the high prevalence of malaria in Nwea District is also being blamed on the deep ditches that have been left behind during road construction, the unhygienic homesteads that are bushy, and the abuse of government mosquito nets.
Our perception of our people is that they don't consider malaria as a very serious problem, as a danger to their livelihood, as a danger to their situations.
Omara Christopher is the Nwea District Resident Commissioner. Today he is speaking to me from under a tangerine tree. And in his observation, the rain season also sees people use the government mosquito nets for grabbing white ants, which are used to prepare a local delicacy known as ajabo.
Sometimes you find people abusing the nets by using them as ropes for tying goats. Sometimes you find people are using the nets for raising seedlings, covering seedlings. Sometimes you find people using nets to take care of the chicks in their compound.
Over the years, the burden caused by malaria has been felt across Uganda. The government had introduced indoor residual spraying, but despite its effectiveness in destroying the Anopheles mosquito, it has proved to be very costly.
Every cluster will have 10 households. The responsibility of these households in a cluster is to ensure that every household in that cluster adheres to malaria prevention and control measures. Every cluster will have a head, and this head reports to the VHT.
The Ministry of Health has now launched a household campaign against malaria. It is known as HOKAM. The campaign is targeting to create household champions to work hand in hand with the village health teams, which are locally known as VHTs, and the LOC1s, to advocate for best practices such as clean compounds, clearing of bushes, and planting trees that repel mosquitoes.
Our main objective is to ensure that we reduce malaria in these areas.
According to the World Health Organization, Uganda has the world's highest malaria incidence rate of 478 cases per 1,000 population per year. It is also the leading cause of sickness and death in Uganda and is responsible for up to 40% of all outpatient visits, 25% of hospital admissions, and 14% of all hospital deaths.
Malaria always affects our household, so all of us are to be champions in our own capacity, ensuring our compound is clean, ensuring there is no bushes around our compound.
Malaria is caused by the Plasmodium parasite. The parasite is spread to humans through the bites of infected mosquitoes.